What if I told you the greatest basketball player in the history of the sport had a thing for punching his own teammates, preferably in the face? Like, he cocked his arm back, swung for the fences, and unlike his baseball career, MJ connected like Tyson. I'm Frank Smith, and this is the Michael Jordan punching his teammates story. Allow me to provide some context. In the 2018 season, the NBA world was fixated with Kevin Durant and Draymond Green after they were shown on camera jawing at each other after a loss. Now, some across the NBA insisted this signaled Durant's departure from the Bay. While he did relocate to Brooklyn, could one little squabble really have made Durant skip town? It's dubious at best. But the media made it seem like Durant and Green were at war. Clips of the argument were played 24/7 on every sports network, all because of a misunderstanding between teammates. And this brings us to the star of Space Jam and other big screen blockbusters such as, well, it was just Space Jam. One can't even imagine what would have transpired 30 years ago if reporters had the same technology to cover Michael Jordan. His airness is famous for being a basketball god, but not a very benevolent one. Jordan's goal on the basketball court wasn't just to beat you, it was to rip your throat out. The internet is full of mythical tales of Jordan's trash talking. He would beat guys down physically and mentally, no matter who was on the other end of the court. In fact, Jordan didn't care if you wore the same uniform as him. If you were guarding him, you were the enemy. Jordan did not take prisoners. MJ would swing on anyone who raised his ire, and there were at least three recorded instances where teammates took a punch because they crossed Black Jesus. Perhaps the most famous teammate who Jordan physically fought is none other than Steve Kerr. The Warriors head coach was a sharpshooting guard who won his first championship with the Bulls in 96, playing the role of a spot shooter and pesky white guy defender. Kerr had moxie and was full of grit, probably woke up every single day blessed, grinding away at the lab. Kerr and Jordan both played the guard spot. In practice, they matched up frequently, and Kerr wasn't ready to back down to the legend. One day, Kerr got fed up. Jordan's trash talk was just too much. He decided to get in Jordan's grill. He attempted to test fate. And as we all know, fate isn't to be trifled with. We don't have footage of the fight, but we do have a before and after image. Kerr claims he kicks Jordan's ass. The photo evidence begs to differ. Steve Kerr isn't the only guard who got his face rocked by a Jordan haymaker. Judd Bushler became a key bench player for the Bulls and another target for MJ. The 6'6 second round pick was also known to get into it with Jordan during practice. But as we're learning, who wasn't? Phil Jackson would push Jordan's buttons by making a play on the second team to fire him up. This meant Jordan wasn't only on the same team as Judd, but even on the same practice team. Somehow, poor Bushler still ended up taking a shot. Now, we don't know much about the Bushler-Jordan showdown, and this is most likely thanks to Coach Jackson for putting a screen around the practice courts. It was hard to get any juicy info from these Bulls teams. Giving MJ the benefit of the doubt here though, he's currently 2-0 in teammate fisticuffs. So far, we got two guys going mano a mano with one of the best who ever lived. Now, you might be thinking, I thought Jordan was tough. Why is he taking on dudes who are his size or smaller? I want to see a real fight. Enter Will Perdue. For reference, here is the size difference between the two. Perdue is a legit 7-footer. Doesn't look like much weight, but he's definitely got Jordan beat in the reach category. Didn't matter. Anyone who got in Jordan's bad side got a fist to the face. In one particular scrimmage, Perdue was feeling feisty. He hit Jordan with a rough pick, which definitely would have been illegal in today's NBA, but was probably passable in the 90s. Jordan gave Perdue a warning. If it happened again, it was going to get messy. Jackson, always the instigator here, called for the play to be run again. Perdue must have eaten his Wheaties because sure enough, he knocked Jordan to the floor with the same pick. The ever-forgettable William Perdue was out here trying to go to war with his airness. He had to know he was going to get it. Perdue was the recipient of an MJ combo and was quickly pulled away from Jordan by his teammates. But he had earned MJ's respect, because apparently that's one way to do it in the Book of Jordan. So there are the three teammates that we know of who Jordan beat up like a bully at recess. Who knows what other confrontations Jordan got into behind the scenes? There are two takeaways from this. One, Jordan is one of the most hard-nosed competitors of all time. Who tries to KO the guys who are working with you to get a championship? The second point is that these men won championships together. Perdue, Kerr, and Bushler might have gotten hit in the face, but they popped back up and played their way right into the history books. Maybe the fighting even helped a little. Essentially, Michael Jordan taught us that we should all fist fight each other because it means we'll all win NBA Finals. I think it's something like that. There's semantics involved, but listen, go punch your colleagues or your classmates right now, then tell your boss about it. He'll respect you for it and give you a raise. Trust me. So, the next time you hear two players yell at each other in practice or the sideline, don't lose your head. Who knows? Maybe they're on their way to basketball greatness too. Big thank you to all who watched and to the tremendous team at Clutch Points who helped produce this. I'm Frank Smith. You can follow me at @FMS_FrankSmith and follow Clutch Points at Clutch Points. Furthermore, if you just want to follow your team, just type in @ThatName plus Nation plus CP to Instagram. For example, @BullsNationCP. In the comments on this one, let me know if you think the fights helped or hurt MJ's Bulls teams. Till next time.